D-Day. On D-Day, which was June 6, 1944, we had loaded all our vehicles and were on our way to the south coast of Britain. And we didn't know it was D-Day until we passed through a small village and we heard the people say, "The invasion's on, here come the bloody meat wagons," you know, meaning the ambulances. And that's the first we knew about. But we got down to the coast of England in time to see the huge armada of airplanes and ships and gliders going constantly into Normandy, and how the Germans, I mean, why anybody had to die after that is beyond me. Why they didn't just, they tried to get rid of Hitler, but they couldn't do it.
Were you excited of the prospect to enter the first actual fights?
Yes, we were excited. Definitely. We first went into action at Avranches, which is in Normandy, in the breakout on the Brest Peninsula. And that was our first action. And it was summer. It was August 1st. And we pulled into a field where there were many wounded, and we started loading wounded. We were with the 4th Armored, which we were with at the end, but in the meantime, we're different. But I remember the first load of casualties so well. I can just see it in my mind today, in a field. And we were lined up, the ambulances, and we loaded these fellows in, 4 litters, 2 on top, 2 on the bottom. And a medical officer came along and said, "Pull him out, he's dead." And I'll never forget that. And we took him out and put someone else in, and then we were going to try to keep track of the people we carried. But by the 3rd or 4th day, we gave it up, and it was a bad scene.